students are showing seven civilian life.
All right. We back. Hold up. Let's rewind that a little bit. The battle is almost over, but the war is about to begin. What are you talking about? I am him, AM. I don't know when I'm going to change that name, but I'm going to come up with something else. But anyway, Kanye West, Drake, the debacle, everything that's going on, they both of their albums is out. I got Kanye winning on the album itself. Sales, I don't know. But as overall, like, for what I want from an album, I have Kanye winning on that. He gave me everything, every box I want to check. From the music production, from the creativity of all the visuals, the features itself, him, his rapping, his singing, his message, all of the substance that he has, just everything about it. As far as like an artist, this is what I wanted from an artist. I wanted to peer into the mind of an artist, and that's what Kanye West has given me. Certified Lover Boy didn't give me that. It was kind of the repetitive thing that I've heard all the time from Drake since he's really been out. It's just newer beats, newer features. Other than that, it's the same old thing. With this, it was passionate. With Donda, it was passionate. It was a message, a lot of substance. It's something that when you hear years from now, you could just appreciate all the different things about the album. Certified Lover Boy just felt like a gimmick. Now, one thing about Drake is his ability to battle and stepping out to battle people. He has been direct when it came time to actually having a back and forth with people. But Kanye West, I don't really expect him to diss people like that. Like, I know he's had problems and issues. He's a human being, and that's what any human being is privy to, have problems. But you don't really hear him being that vocal and that direct. Unless it's like one of those breakdown things where it's really, really deep to him. Then he'll be kind of direct like he was with Jay-Z and a few people. But as far as like on a record making a diss song and all of that, this was really interesting. The level that he's at in his career and everything that he's done, it's just funny that you know when other top tier people is noticing the other top tier people. Like, you hear Kendrick talking about smoking on a pack. Hold on. That's where I'm at, ho. But that's not what we came here for. Y'all know what we came here for, man. Let's get into this shit right quick. In America today. First off, Andre 3000. Oh my God. Hold on, what did he say? To think I could have almost died. Almost died for this.
Hey, Miss Donda, you run and tell my mama, please tell her I said say something. No, after over, this is it done. If there's a heaven, you would think they let you speak to your son. Maybe she has in the form of a baby's laugh. I heard passing by in a stroller reminded me, hey, keep rolling. Oh no, maybe she has with the.
Now that's just like the deeper part of the song, you know, the inspiration and the story of his connection Kanye West, I guess, and his mom, and lessons of his own mother, and how they both related. They both had a demise with the same thing, and that was the deeper part of the song. But we gonna be real. Andre smoked that, and he did it like no other. But this is it.
Name was Mrs. Wu. She was strict and it said that's hand made everyone mad. He made 808, so he's everyone dead. No, he ever gets that hope. Jerome's by the shore. Close my eyes, I can see more. Nobody punking me, nobody pressuring me, nobody gangsta me. Especially when the gangsters eat thanks to me. And my favorite principal name was Mrs. Wu. She was strict, the perfect instructor for young Putin. Vladimir, just so that is clear. Whom should we fear when we know dad is here?
Daddy right here. Daddy right here.
I don't play boy, for my daughter pose a play. That sicko mode was his biggest song. We're gone, cause Donda was the best ghostwriter I ever had. Every in my back, this house of pain won't ever last. So I had told me to my face. That sicko mode was his biggest song. We're gone, cause Donda was the best ghostwriter I ever had. South Park had jokes about fist sticks. To this day, the whole team could kiss this dick. I put Virgil and Drake on the same text. And it wasn't about the matching Arc'teryx or Kid Cudi dress. Just told these grown men, stop it with the funny shit.
Mm-hmm.
I might hire the whole team from ACG.
Right.
So don't text me like I'm Juanita JCV. Or more important, Monica Corgan, who was there for me. Somebody really there for me was rare for me. That was new air to breathe. When I was underappreciated, undervaluated. Stockholders told me boardrooms would bore you. Hey, remember.
Pause that real quick. I want y'all to hear something. I want y'all to hear something. Put on your ears. Do you hear the delivery? Do you hear the cadence? Do you hear the flow? Who do it sound like? Before you answer that, just listen to who's rapping it. And remember this style years ago. Remember all the auto-tune, all of the things. Remember him, Wayne, and T-Pain was like the auto-tune people. They was the people with these kind of styles coming out, especially with, the reason why I'm saying this is because you're hearing the master version of this, of that flow and delivery, that cadence, that just overall style of rapping, and it's coming from Kanye West. Just think about that as we continue.
By your rules, try to follow the Lord's rules. Y'all, it was the new Abu Dhabi. Told Drake, don't play with me on GD. And he sent that message to everybody. So if I hit you with a WYD, you better hit me with, yes, sir, I'm writing everything you need. I told you I was gonna take the summer back. So any other cap won't take none of that. Wear my motherfucking red hat. Security and the nannies be forever handling. I can't stand it when it's talks of putting the kids back in Sierra Canyon when daddy got his own school. Trash mouth for these white people if you want. Why we build a team to get Hoover out the joint? I do what I want, bro, in my life. Serve and protect long as it's my wife. Screaming.
All right. So now I'm just waiting for the response. That's all. I'm just waiting on the response. I gotta hear the response before I make a full judgment of this. But this right here is nice. I like this. This is why I'm saying Kendrick, like I said on the last video, if Kendrick come out with a diss to anybody, it does have to be direct. Joe Wright, Joe Budden Podcast, they right. It has to be direct. This is direct things happening. Even Drake has stepped into a direct lane when he's dissed. And honestly, if Drake was to respond to this, another prediction, like I predicted on the last album, is it's going to sound like this, or it's going to be a party version of this. But the cadence, the delivery, the flow, that's what I was saying before. It's going to sound like this. And I just want y'all to pay attention to that. If Drake responds, and you know he most likely will, just pay attention to how it sounds. Then go back to this song. Then listen to that one. Then go back again. Then everything else I have to judge on this, he has to beat the production. He has to beat a lot of things in this song. So, it ain't just no regular diss. You know, fuck that nigga, go to hell. Nah. This is... Man, this is one of them ones. Are they going to go back and forth? That's what I want to know. Are they going to continue to go back and forth? Because this was unreleased and people keep like leaking it everywhere. So now it's like, well, I don't know. But I'm ready for it. I'm here for it. So far, man, Kanye seemed like he is up and ready. Pause if need be.